With such intense levels of competition, it is crucial for UTS to distinguish itself from the other market competitors. However, universities, being very similar in their functions, find it difficult to find differentiation between themselves. So, one of our recommendations is appealing to international students. So just to get a rough idea, how many of you in this class are actually international students? Do you mind just chucking your hands up for a quick... Alright, let's go here. Do you feel like UTS provides, like... do you think it could further benefit itself if it provided better resources for international students?
Yes.
Yep. Okay. There's evidence for you.
Couple of one. Well...
Just for some statistics, UTS has a relatively low level of international students compared to its competitors, being at only 20%, whereas at the University of Sydney, they have international students sitting at 32%, and at UNSW, their international students are at 34%. This, as a result, sees a decrease in revenue and a loss of competitors. So, how can we make UTS even better than it already is?
We have a few strategy recommendations that UTS can do. One of it is to embrace the technology in the, you know, in University of Technology Sydney. So technology itself, it's not really as advanced as it's promoting. So one of ways of doing it is to, you know, use UTS Online as not only as a database for just lecture notes and tutorial slides. And a way of doing this is maybe to provide live streaming of lectures. Like most of you all know, we hate lectures, and therefore lecture recordings are a bit of a help, but then it's not really on every subject. So live streaming of lectures, probably like listening to lectures maybe on your train or something, and then maybe have a chat on the live stream so that it's interactive, because in recorded lectures, it's not really like, you can't really ask the lecturer stuff. Also, like, we could always use virtual reality, and like maybe it's not for business students, but maybe for science students, it's easier for them to maybe see the human body and like through virtual reality. And lastly, we can use like integrate e-devices and subjects, because subjects such as this one, maybe, like they say, oh, turn off your e-devices, but then it's 2019, and therefore like e-devices are very important for learning. Like most of the learning is not on paper anymore, it's on e-devices. And as my partner Alex said, one of the biggest problems with UTS is its lack of international students. Therefore, we need to accommodate like the interest of international students. I myself is an international student, and I don't think there's much help, because, you know, in that case, and therefore like using the visual methods, which is what we research as, you know, what international students prefer. So maybe using like visual graphs, and therefore more interactive, like in the one I mentioned, the technology. Another way of doing this is to use UTS's website, such as like UTS Online and Library, and like maybe like class selection website to be more accessible. Because I think, from what I heard anyways, like even domestic students speaking who have English as their first language are having trouble with the website. Like imagine like students with not like English as their second language, and that's like a big problem. And lastly, can you raise your hand if any of you were here like last semester? You with a striped shirt. Well, you were here last semester, right?
Yeah.
Did you do a social justice program kind of thing, like consent? Or?
Yeah, I did the consent thing.
So do you think it's beneficial?
Yeah, it was good. And you should let everyone have to do it, so that everyone knows what's going on.
And do you think there should be more of that, or?
Yeah, I guess so.
Alright, cool. Yeah, we also think there's more of that, because like UTS just started last semester, while other unis have been starting like years prior, and it's only for consent. Maybe like, because UTS has been in their strategy plan, 2027 strategy plan, they've been saying to be the leading university in the world for global impact, and to be the first indigenous residential college, and that's like, they're not really putting programs for that, so maybe more programs for social justice and equality. By following these strategies, UTS is also like gain a competitive edge in this highly saturated market, like because UTS is here and its competitor just across the, like down the road, use it, and like, and it'll be more attractive to international students too. Like, you know, international students will see like, oh, this uni uses VR, that's not something other unis do in Australia, and yeah, that's it for us.
Any questions?